Welcome back. In this video, we will apply joints to this assembly. Whenever we have this icon, this denotes a component. So here we have five components. And if we expand a component, we can see here an origin for axis and planes and body. In this instance, this component already has a body. In addition, I can create a new component without a body. So here, for now, it is empty because we haven't created anything yet. I'm going to hit Ctrl Z on my keyboard to revert back. In addition, if we desire to edit or update a specific component, what we have to do is activate this, and from here, we can make changes or improvement to our target component. And that's the basics on what a component is in Fusion 360. And finally, before we add joints, make sure that our main assembly is activated. Moving forward, notice when we create a new design, we have here our timeline. And whenever we import something in Fusion 360, typically our timeline is not present. Now, the importance of having a timeline is to capture the design history. Now, to enable this, we simply need to head to our main assembly or main file, right-click, and select Capture Design History. So now we have our timeline once more. Now, the advantage of having a timeline is we can go back in time to perform a specific edit to our model. Now, as we make changes to our model, our actions will be registered here, giving us the option to make edits or revisions back and forth. Let's now inspect our model. For me, I prefer whenever we head to home view, the pose of our model should be similar to this position. So I'm going to head to our view cube, select the corner of the cube, and double click our scroll wheel to zoom extents, head back to our home view icon, right click, and select set current view as home, fit to view. So from here, whenever we hit home, we will be going back to our preferred position. In addition, I prefer that our front view to replace our bottom view. Now, to do this, I'm going to select bottom, double click our middle mouse to zoom extents, head to our view cube, right click, and select set current view as front. Heading back to home view. Previously, when capture design history was not present, all of our components were grounded. Now, with capture design history in effect, we can now freely move our components. So, join me in the next lesson as we finally add intelligence to our assembly by adding joints.